friends, welcome to our show. Today we are going to discuss about the problem of enlarged prostate in men above 50 years. And let me introduce Dr. Pradeep Mule, Senior Consultant Interventional Radiology, practicing in New Delhi, India. Welcome to the show, Dr. Mule.
Talking about treatments, what are the treatments for the enlarged prostate? How can it be cured?
Treatment option, the various options are there. Mm-hmm. One is the medical management.
Okay.
And lot of researchers, they still wanted to found some kind of the medication which controls the enlarged prostate symptoms, but it still is not the perfect medication is there.
Okay.
Some are the 10 to 20% of the male, they may sometime get some temporary relief also, and some may not get also. So the other surgical options are there, and in surgical option, there's so many options are there. Like TURP, one surgery is there, when the laser surgery is there. Now the so many the green light and other kind of the surgery also available. But these all surgery is done under the anesthesia.
Okay.
And this done through the penis, go inside and whatever the area of the enlarged prostate gland, they take out from that area and they come out.
Okay, so this seems to be very risky also.
Yeah, so these like the one is the medical management, one is the surgical management.
Mm-hmm.
But now when you see that like the another new line of the management which is very promising to treat the enlarged prostate, that is called as the prostatic artery embolization. This is the technique exactly what normally the intervention radiologists all over the world, they do for a uterine fibroid also.
Okay, so this is a non-surgical
treatment. Technique.
Yeah. Okay. So, but is the prostatic artery embolization a safe procedure?
It is a very safe procedure, and particularly when you see that this technique is done under the local anesthesia. And when you see the during the surgery time, because this happens, the enlargement of the prostate gland at the aging process, maybe the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, right? So that time, the lot of male, they have some other comorbidity also. They may have sometime the cardiac problems. They may have the hypertension also, may sometime the diabetic also. So these are the comorbidity are there. They may tolerate that kind of the major surgery or may not be also. So if you compare with that one, so this is the done under the prostatic artery embolization done under the local anesthesia. And this need just the only the one day hospitalization. And this not need any surgical scar also.
Okay.
And no risk for a bleeding during the procedure. This just like a simple angiography. We go through the groin area, we make the one small puncture. The puncture also is very similar to what the way you do the blood sample.
Okay.
And through that, we take one small tube inside, we go identify the prostatic artery, and whatever the abnormal arteries which supplying to the enlarged prostate, that we block by the one medication which is the two kind of the medications now available. One is the ambosphere is there, one is the polyvinyl or cold particles are there. These two particles are available. And the next day patient can go home also in this technique.
Okay, so it doesn't need any recovery time, you mean to say. And what can the patient expect during this procedure?
Patient expect only the like when you give the local anesthesia, patient can talk to the doctor very well during the procedure.
Okay.
Because patient is fully conscious.
Conscious.
He has to lie down for around like 20 to 30 minutes time. And we give the local anesthesia, that may be the little like mild pain kind of things are there. But in the same time, some of the patient are very apprehensive, right? So we give them some mild pain medication, this thing also.
Okay, but talking about this non-surgical procedure, what exactly happened to the prostate after this prostatic artery embolization?
Once you block the abnormal blood supply to the prostate gland, enlarged prostate gland, right? So in a due course of the time, in a 2 week or 3 week time, they start getting the shrinkage and this become a little softer also.
Okay.
So that relieve the symptoms. This causes the less compression over the prostatic urethra. So if the compression is not there in the urethra, so they may get all the symptom relief like their hesitation, narrow stream. Even though they have the sexual condition, that also improves after these procedures.
Is there any specific enlarged size of the enlarged prostate which cannot be treated by PAE?
See, the enlargement of the prostate, normally when I do my OPDs, that time I see the various sizes of the gland that may sometime measured by the grams also. Suppose I seen the one patient at the time that prostate gland gram wise is around like the 100 gram, but sometimes the patient say I don't have any problem.
Okay.
But sometimes even at 25 gram or 30 gram of the prostate, that if the causing the compression over the urethra, right, so they may get the terrible problems also.
Okay.
So if a patient is asymptomatic, then definitely you have to treat.
Okay.
Right? Size does not make much difference on the line of management. Patient has to be symptomatic.
Okay, what are the advantages of prostatic artery embolization?
This is the biggest advantage as compared to the surgical procedures, because this is done in the local anesthesia, and particularly the prostatic artery embolization, these techniques don't have any kind of the complication what normally we see in the surgeries. In surgeries like a bleeding, incontinence, need a urine bag and that catheter for a 1 week, 2 week, 3 week, this does not happen into the prostatic artery embolization. And I know that the most of the male with that age group or any age group, then nobody like to take a urine bag and just roaming around for 2 or 3 weeks, right?
Yes.
So this hampers their day-to-day activities also. And even in this technique is the no blood loss.
Okay.
Like in surgery, the lot of blood loss also there sometimes. That depend upon the what kind of the surgery you are doing. But in prostatic artery embolization, is the no blood loss, no need to ask for a blood transfusion also. And the mobility and the routine activities and other things, like suppose if you do the today the prostatic artery embolization, the next day they can resume the normal work. Even next day they can drive the car, they can go to the office. So this become a very easy. Even one of the biggest advantage, right, after the surgery, the man, they may lose sometimes the sexual activities and other things also. But after the prostatic artery embolization, this gives the enhancement to their these all the things.
Okay, so they became more healthy and active.
When you see that this kind of the technique, when they started in Europe, right, so now being in the other Western countries also. So most of the people, they are attracted just because of the one reason, this don't give any sexual dysfunction.
Okay.
So that's the biggest advantage in the prostate.
Generally, people will look forward for this. Does the prostate grow back after the PAE treatment?
PAE treatment, as compared to the open surgeries and the other surgeries, right, this is a very new kind of the technique is there. All over the world, till now, the 4 to 5 year experience is there.
Okay.
But good number of the literature, they say the recurrence is not there after the prostatic artery embolization.
That's quite good.
The time will tell after the like a 5 year and 6 year and 10 years, right? But if the person goes on this one, at least they don't lose anything, right? So they will get a very good results in the by the prostatic artery embolization.
Okay, and the prostatic artery embolization, you said that the non-surgical procedure is.
Yes.
Very much beneficial over the surgical procedure. So the non-surgical procedure, is it covered under insurance?
Yeah, it's a good number of the insurance now they started covering.
Okay.
Initially what happens, like when you send this new kind of the technique to the insurance people, right? Insurance people also sometimes very blank, they don't know about that. But now they started knowing that no, this is giving the good results, lot of literatures and other things are available. So some are the insurance definitely that covers the prostatic artery embolization procedure.
Okay. So is this procedure any painful?
No, not at all. This is just mild pain is there. The simple, only the simple pain medication is more than enough. When they go home also, they not need to be take so much pain medication. Only like after the procedure, we give the 3 to 4 and 5 days antibiotic as a prophylactic. That's all.
Again, after the non-surgical procedure, till how long one can get back to his work?
2 days.
Only 2 days.
Less than 2 days, you can say.
Okay, so 2 days can be said as the recovery period.
Yeah, recovery.
For that. Okay. And talking about follow-ups, what are the follow-ups and precautions required after this treatment?
Normally, the prostatic artery embolization, what normally the international standard is there, right? Normally, I used to call after the 7 days and then after a month. After 7 days, only the purpose to call them to see that any kind of the infection sign is there or not. Otherwise, you can start that medication.
Okay.
After the 1 month, we do the repeat ultrasonography to find out how much the reduction of the size is there and how much the improvement is there clinically.
Okay.
Right, that does not make any difference on the size reduction is the how much. I just wanted to know that the how much the your symptom is gone, what the your problem is gone down after the treatment. That's all the follow.
Okay, and what's the cost of this treatment? How much expensive is it?
Cost of, as compared to the surgery is definitely less because need not anesthesia, need just the one day admission. Not need is so many antibiotic and so many medication, also the cost automatically is come down for a prosthetic artery and blood.
How successful is this procedure in controlling the symptoms of enlarged prostate?
Yeah, this is the one very good question. And overall, when you see that, like any size of the prostate, when you do the prosthetic artery embolization, around 95 to 98% of the people, they get the really great results. 1% of the people, they may not get the good results, but who are them is difficult to identify before doing the prosthetic artery embolization. These all depend upon the how vascularity is there in the prostate.
Okay, that doesn't have any concern with the age.
No, because this is done in the local anesthesia, so you don't consider there the comorbidity, other problem of the patient.
And I would really thank you to sharing this information to the people, because generally the male at the elderly age generally suffer from enlarged prostate gland and they look for surgeries even. But looking at your episode, they will be relieved, I'm sure. Thank you.
Thank you very much.